So today we're going to talk about how to install the TMC2208 on the SKR version 1.2. So I'm going to zoom in on the stepper for a moment. And as you can see, there is a little bit of writing on the top right here that says the enable pin. And notice how the other stepper, I have a actual heat fins on it. This is to wick away the heat. You want to actually run this with a fan to keep them cool. But what we're going to have to do right now is figure out how to actually install these. So if we look at the board, we can see that there's jumpers currently set for it. These are not the correct configuration for actually using it. So we have to find out what the actual jumper setting will be. So we're going to go over to the web browser for a second, and what we're going to do is look at the actual configuration that we see for BigTreeTech's SKR Pro. There's actually a folder inside for the version 1.2. And down here they have the manual. So we're going to click on here to see what the manual actually says. And so I'm going to scroll down kind of quick. I might stop on a couple of things, but let's see what we have. So as we get down here, they say that this is used for USB power, and this is used for actual power from your power supply. In order to use these steppers, you need to use the power from your power supply for the jumper. And I'll point that out in a second on the board. Then down here, they talk about the actual steppers. So you have your X stepper, your Y stepper, your Z stepper. So you have two connections that you can use, E0, E1, and E2, which are used for extrusion. And as you can see over here, they write enable by the pin that will be actually right here. So now that we know that, we need to go through the actual stepper configurations. This is step dir, which is not what we're going to be using it for. We're going to be using it for UART, so we're going to go right here. So for UART mode, we need to know which pins to short, and here they are. So let's go back to the board and set that up. So on the board, I'm going to pop off these jumpers for the X-axis. Might take a little bit of work. There we go. Now that I have them off, I'm going to put it on the jumper for the UART mode, which is right over here, and push it down. Next, I'm going to pick up the stepper, and as you can see, it's red on one side, black on the other. So that's a clue as to how to connect it. So you're going to connect it right over in here, and then you're going to apply a little bit of thumb pressure to put that in place. And while I'm at it, I'm going to put the actual motor connection in with the DuPont connector. So we're all set there, and the jumper is in direct power, so we need to set this up. Currently it's de-energized, which means there's no power going to it. So we're going to use a screwdriver to connect the power. So you need two different powers. You need board power and you need stepper power. So we're doing the steppers first. So I'm going to tighten this down. Then I'm going to do the ground, and notice how I've marked with red on the top of the screw so I know which one to connect. Now I'm going to grab the next cable and do the same. This is board power. So I'm going to tighten that down, and currently I'm using 12 volts. Now you can use 24 volts as well, but I prefer using 12 on my boards. So I'm going to clip that down just for safety. Now we can't load the software via USB, so we need to pop out the drive and we need to connect it to our RocketTech, which will allow us to connect to our actual configuration. So this will connect to our computer. Now keep in mind that I'm going to plug this into my computer and let you know that no one's paying me or sponsoring me to do this tutorial, but I will place Amazon affiliate links in the description for your convenience. So now that we have that set up, let's go over to VScode. Inside VScode, what we're going to do is we're actually going to configure our configuration. So what I want to do is actually show you how to load it. So I'm going to click on the Explorer over here, then open folder. Then I'm going to go to my downloads folder where Marlin is already extracted. I'm going to open that up, the second Marlin, then select the folder. Inside here, I'm going to click on the Marlin folder, then the source, then the core folder. Then I'll click on boards.h and we'll find our board, which we'll do with the search of SKR underscore pro. And as you can see, our board's located right here, so I'm going to copy that. Then I'm going to close out of boards.h. I'm going to minimize core and source and go to configuration.h. Inside here, I'm going to search on motherboard. And I'm going to highlight the ramps board and paste over it with ours. Now I need to change the serial port from 0 to -1. And then I need to search on our stepper. So A4988 will be what we'll initially search on. I'll remove the comment so that we can actually use it. And then I'll take the TMC2208 and copy that. And then paste it right here. So that's all you have to do to configure it here. You may have to invert it depending upon where your end stops are. But I'll show you that in just a second. But first I want to show you this. It's default access steps per unit. So in order to set this up, what we need to do is go over to configuration advanced.h and search on 800. And right here is the stepper that we're currently using. Notice the 16. This stepper can do from 0 to 256th of a step. So we're going to start at 16, but if we change this, being the 80 to 160, then we need to double this value. So we'll change the 16 to a 32. If we were to increase it some more, we'd have to do 320. And then the same thing occurs here where it's 64 and so on and so forth until you reach 256. So now that we have that covered, I'm going to show you how to set this up. We're going to first set up debugging. So TMC underscore debug. And we're going to remove the comment right here so that we can use the G code M122 to find out if our stepper is installed correctly. And then we're going to search on it a second time. And remove the comment as well. So we're all set there. Now let's go back to configuration.h for a second, and I'm going to show you the invert. So if you search on invert, you can see down here that we can invert the direction. So if your end stop is in the opposite direction that it should be, you can change the false to a true, but I'm going to leave it alone for now. Now to set up the actual build, we have to go over to platformio.ini, and right now the default environment is the Mega2560. So we need to search on our environment, which is SKR underscore pro, copy that environment, and then scroll back up. So at the top, we'll paste it right here. And then to compile, before you compile, try doing the clean in case there's anything in your .pio folder. That'll get everything out of it. And then we need to click the checkbox for build. And this will take a few moments to build. If there's an issue, you can always build the second time. As you can see here, I have an issue. So let's see what it is real quick. So this seems like a strange issue, so I'm going to try build again. Now, normally if you do have an issue, it's always the first one. And then the other ones are usually caused by a cascade of errors that occur thereafter. So always go for the first thing that the compiler or build fails on. So once this completes, we're going to go to our .pio folder. You can see there's now a build folder and an SKR Pro folder. And inside here, you'll see a firmware.bin. So right click on that go to Reveal and Explorer, and inside here, what you're going to do is right-click again, and you're going to say Send to your D drive. And that's the drive that we pulled out of the SKR Pro version 1.2. So you can see there's a firmware.cur with a load on it. The firmware.bin will replace that after it loads and rename itself to firmware.cur for current in all capital letters if your load is successful. So I'm going to go over to the desktop for a second and I'm going to install this. So I'm going to take this out of here, place it inside the SD drive, plug in the power for the USB, even though we're not going to be using it right away. And then I'm going to plug in the power for the board. And you can see now that there's a flashing green light. That's your firmware loading. So once that completes, we're going to go over to Pronterface. And inside Pronterface, what we're going to do is actually connect to the board. Now, I've already done this before today, so I don't know what the actual COM port is, so I need to go to my device manager and sort this out. So I'm gonna type in device manager, and it'll come up, and you can see right here that there's a port 17. The other one is default for the computer of COM port 1, and I only have one thing plugged in with this COM port. So I'm gonna close that. I'm gonna go over here and I'm gonna change the 10 to a 17. Then I'm gonna press connect. Down here you can see that it says connecting and printer is now online. So to test this, what we're gonna do is we're gonna type M122 and press enter. And this will let us know if we're okay, which it says. So let's try and move this now and see what happens. Now I don't have end stops connected, so we're just gonna be able to move back and forth. So let's move 10. So it's moving 10. Now let's try 100 in the other direction. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.